Om Namah Shivaya students, we are presently doing the chapter Motion and Measurement of Distances. It is the chapter number 10 of class 6 science. Today we are going to continue with this chapter. In the last class students, I have done one topic that while measuring length we need to take care of the following. I have discussed it with you in the last class. Did you understand, students? Because this is a very practical thing that we do in our life every day. Probably whenever we are measuring something with a scale, then we do these things. But whenever we are writing those points point-wise, then we need to understand. Okay, I am explaining it once more to you. That whenever we are measuring any object by the help of a scale, we should, means our eyes should be in straight contact, okay? So that is why it is written, place the scale in contact with the object along with its length. Means the scale should be placed on the object along with its length straight, okay? That is my first work. Now the second one is, the second point is optional. Means if the scale is broken, then only we have to do this subtraction part. Suppose if I am starting the measurement from 1 centimeter, then at the end whatever measurement I am getting, suppose here I have given an example 14.3 centimeters, so I am subtracting 1 centimeter from that. But if the scale has no broken portion and I am starting the measurement from 0, then there is no need of this kind of subtraction procedure. Okay, this is optional. And number 3, what I was telling at the beginning, correct position of the eye, means you should have a straight contact with the measuring object and the ruler. Okay, I have explained this once more so that you are able to understand. Okay, now today we will discuss about a few more measurement. Suppose measuring the length of a curved line. When we are measuring a table or we are measuring a straight line, then we can use a ruler or the measuring tape like this. Now what to do if we are measuring a curved line? What kind of curved line? See, here is a diagram of that. Suppose this is a point A and this is a point B, and these two points are joined by the help of this curved line. So if the line is curved, it is very difficult for us to use a ruler to measure it, isn't it? So what they are doing, see, the person has taken one thread. This black color thing is a thread, and he is using the thread to measure the curved line at first. Means how much thread? Means he is taking a thread. He is starting from this point, suppose first from here to here, then he is again holding from here to here, then he is again holding this curved portion, then here to here, then here to here. Then the total portion up to B, whatever thread is needed, he is cutting that piece of thread. See, this is that piece of thread. Now this piece of thread is measured by the help of either measuring tape, or you can take a ruler, whatever. Means first you are measuring the curved line by the help of a thread, then that thread you are measuring with the help of a ruler or any other instrument which we use to measure length. I hope I am clear. So it is written that we cannot measure the length of a curved line directly by using a meter scale. It is very difficult, as I said. So we can use a thread to measure the length of a curved line. Then we can easily measure the thread by using a tape or a ruler. Okay. Now here, see, sometimes the ants, this is also there in your book as an activity. Okay. Sometimes ants also move on the floor or on a piece of paper. And you will see when the ants are moving, they are also moving in a curved line. They are not moving in straight lines. So if you want to measure the distance, that how much an ant is traveling on a piece of paper, that activity is also given in your book. See, because the ant is moving in a curved line, so the process will be the same, this measuring with a thread. But let us see how they are telling. Suppose this is a piece of paper, this picture is given in your book also, and there are some pieces of sugar over here. This blue pieces are pieces of sugar, and so the ant is traveling. So whenever the ant is traveling in a curved line, the book is telling that when the ant is traveling behind the ant, means as the ant is going ahead, you are using a pencil to draw the line behind the ant. And then ultimately, when the ant is traveling from this paper to or this sheet of paper or this piece of cloth, whatever, or a table, whatever, you are using a pencil to draw the line. And when the ant is moving from this portion, then they are telling that this line, what you are getting, is the path of the means the traveling way of the ant. And now you can use a piece of thread to measure that, and then that piece of thread you can measure by the help of a scale or a measuring tape, whatever. So now see students, this ant is a moving body, isn't it? Similarly, there are different other moving bodies, suppose a bird, then the hands of a clock, then butterfly, dog, cow, baby, fish. See, I have given here many examples: moving train, sewing machine. So all these things are there. Sewing machine means what? The machine that we use for stitching. Okay, the tailors use. So when the things are moving, then we cannot measure them by the help of our normal measuring instrument of length. Then we need to think of something different. Actually, there are different types of motion. When there is motion, when the object is fixed, it is very easy for us to measure. But when the object is in motion, then there are actually many number of type of motions. We will discuss about the type of motions in our next video class. There are different types of motion: rectilinear motion, periodic motion, rotational motion. We will discuss about them. Okay, now on the type of movement, we have to decide the type of motion, means how the thing is moving. Suppose the pendulum is moving from left to right, again from right to left. This is the type of motion. So which type of motion it will be, we will discuss in the next class. So remember about that curved line measurement that often comes in exam. Okay, and regarding this motion, the part of the chapter which deals with motion, we will start discussing in the next video class. Till then, students, read the chapter up to here and wait for my next video class. Very soon I will send you the next video class, in which we will discuss about majorly about motion. Om Namah Shivaya.